Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, November 2020. Aries, finally. This is the end for all of the cardinal signs, because they were just crucified in 2020. Whether you're Aries, Cancer, Capricorn, Libra, this is the end. This is the final stretch. It's becoming so much easier because your planet is going to turn direct from the 13th of November, which is great news. It's been retrograde for 2 months almost, basically from September. And you're just going to start noticing from the middle of November that things are turning around. So if there've been delays, frustrations, if you've been working on some project and it's just been taking forever and everyone is, something has been always complicated, something always doesn't go according to expectations, now things will turn around and things will start becoming according to expectations. Another thing is if you've had some very complicated issue happening in your life, for some of you even health issue, because Mars retrograde in our sign, whether it's Sun, Moon or Ascendant, can give sometimes health problems, stresses, nervous tensions and so on, accident proneness. Well, it's a healing time when Mars goes direct, and you're going to start resolving this problem. Other people might have been working very hard preparing for something when Mars was retrograde, having to redo, to fix something. It might have been a project. They might have worked on their physical body or health. Others might have worked on changing the direction of their life somehow. This internal, especially because when it's retrograde, there is a lot of internal work or behind the scene work, behind the scenes that's happening. So now when Mars starts turning direct, finally you start seeing the results of those extra efforts, of those extra, because a retrograde planet is 3 times closer to Earth, so it requires 3 times more effort. So finally you're going to start seeing, you know, it's becoming easier, more effortless. You're going to start feeling like there's finally wind in your sails. Till now, the wind has been in the opposite direction. There was no wind, more like sleep. And finally, you're going to become a force of nature and stampede forward, like we usually like to do as Aries. We just like forward and just go ahead. And we feel a bit frustrated when Mars is retrograde because nothing is moving, or it's happening with a lot of efforts, a lot of obstacles, with a lot of anger as well. And even though we're Aries, they say we anger easy, but we are eager to move away from anger. We anger easy and then, okay, I'm done. I love you. We forgive, we forget, we move on, you know. But when Mars is retrograde, we become more like bearing grudges and some pain, that some especially fiery anger inside that we can't let go of, that we work internally on for 2 months, that we process. And now, release. Okay, you've done the hard work. And I'm amazed how I've seen so many Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising people turn their life around during this Mars retrograde in our sign, which happens once every 40 years. So it's very rare, guys. So I've seen how something shifted in their consciousness because the planet that rules us, it was in our sign, moving in the opposite direction. So we saw things from a different perspective. We worked on a lot of things from the past that needed closure and to end and completion. And we also brought a lot of things to culmination, because when Mars is retrograde, it's its most visible. So something is just like when this full moon, so something comes to fruition, comes to culmination, you know. And now Mars continues to be extremely strong, but it's turning direct. So we're going to start seeing the results of those efforts, of those stresses we've been going through, complicated situations, fights, quarrels with others will be removed. And if even some of you, they have withdrawn a little bit, withdrawn and just taken a step back, like what happened with me is I thought I'd be fighting left and right. The opposite. I actually took a step back and worked very hard on projects and behind the scenes. And it was gruesome. It was like burning the midnight oil type of thing every day without a stop. But I started working out, I stopped drinking, I stopped so many. It's incredible how many transformations happen inside, but it required a lot of mental rewiring, mental discipline, because Mars is the soldier. It's very much about discipline and willpower. So I hope some of you had the ability to focus this willpower internally, to consolidate it and to transform something within yourself that will show, especially now when Mars starts moving direct, it will start making an impact on your external life as well. So you're stronger, maybe a bit battered, but you've kind of like this consolidation of intensity, of willpower and strength. Now you're ready to give a burst through it forward, and all those things that you reprogram within yourself while Mars was retrograde, all those internal battle. And also it means, because Aries rules the head, reprogramming your thoughts for many of you, how you view certain things, reprogramming your inner, what's happening in this beautiful head of yours, the internal thought processes, the very having to reprogram some very obstinate beliefs and obstinate, what is that called? Like opinions that you might have had. And you were able, thanks to Mars retrograde, to do that, many of you. And I heard so many areas says, I've done such incredible internal work. I've withdrawn a bit, but I've never had the willpower to do this before. So well done. If you had external problems, Mars retrograde can also bring that, and external struggles, they're coming to an end. The wind will start turning toward in your direction. You know, the universe is kind. It does not leave us in difficult situations beyond our ability to cope and for too long. So, okay, we're going to start moving ahead. Yes, yeah, slowly, slowly. It's not going to happen overnight, but from the middle of the month, you'll see some good news turns around, some resolution to a problem. That you can move forward and so on, or results of something that you've been working on, you can start bringing them out, externalizing them now. And I kind of mixed a little bit the order, because first Mercury turns direct, guys, in our seventh house, another cardinal house, till around, so the 3rd of November, Mercury starts turning direct. But Mercury was retrograde over the 8th and the 7th house. So if you had some complications connected to relationships, Mercury retrograde in the 7th house, delays of contracts, delays of signing of agreements, complication about agreements with others, and promises that were not kept, or reevaluation of business or personal relationships, which can create a crisis situation. Well, this is changing now. From the beginning of November already, all such problems, delays, especially in seventh house, with relationships, business partnerships, clients, contracts, agreements, they will disappear. Hopefully you'll have way more fair, balanced relationships after that. Some of us might have gone through a little bit of a relationship crisis while Mercury was retrograde there. Some things from the past coming to be talked about. Some things you're not happy that are not fair to be, and even ultimatums to be given, or your side to be spoken, or your partner's side to be heard and say, okay, this is, you know, I'm not okay with that. Can we make some other agreement? Can we change the rules of the game between you and me? Between you and me as a client, or me and you as a business partner, me and you as collaborators, me and you as best friends, me and you as husband, wife, me and you as boyfriend, girlfriend, me and you as contractors. Okay, let's change a little bit. Let's renegotiate. This is what Mercury retrograde was saying till the 3rd of November. Renegotiate the terms and conditions of our relationships. And of course, that can create certain crisis situations, but Mercury is moving out, is starting to move direct. So those issues will be resolved. Some of you might have finished even some relationship if there was no possibility to reach an agreement. Just like there was no possibility in politics to reach agreement recently for signing, you know, anything for helping people and stuff, because Mercury was retrograde. But so things were put on the back burner, but there will be also politically around the world, more kind of because it's in Libra, some more contract sign on whatever, but this is specifically for you. So business partnerships will start moving there ahead, business exchanges, work exchanges, if you work with clients on a one-to-one basis, any kind of complications, delays, or stressful situations there with clear up. You can complete now contracts, agreements, sign up things, because they are, maybe they were delayed, they were more complicated. Now, finally, they can, you know, they'll look better and you can go ahead with those things. And also if your partner had certain complications and stresses, or they took more of a passive role, now Mercury starts moving direct in your seventh house, and this will change as well for them. They'll start moving direct. Personally, for me, I had some complications in my relationships with things that came from the past, and we had to talk about them. So me as an Aries definitely felt that. But still, till the 3rd of November, be cautious, because around this time, still crisis, it's crisis prone. But after that, things change and take a different direction. You might make up your mind in regards to relationships and start acting in that direction, whether you want to stay or go, you know. All right. Then Mercury from around the 10th moves into Scorpio, and it was retrograde for you as well there for a big part of October. So if you had some complications connected to, or hard work connected to taxes, to insurances, inheritances, money from government, money from ex-partners, business partners, money from clients, or resources that are not dependent only on you but on another person, maybe delivery company for some, for your business resources, you know. Well, any such complications will also be resolved in November. Any delays that you expected something to be returned to you, some money that is not yours to come to you, or some delays with and frustrations with mutual finances with your partner as well, they'll be solved and they'll start moving in the direction you want. Unpredictable situations and less situations connected to mutual finances, you know. For example, for me, it was my husband was super stressed with taxes and stuff. So we had to, our Mercury was retrograde in my 7th, 8th house. We just had to redo taxes. You know, it's like by the book, it was this October. It's like more, let's find more expenses, you know, let's redo them. So it means the end of it, seeing the results, end of such problems. Positive resolutions, if there were some complications with your partner's finances, so even your finances, because Mercury retrograde from the 8th makes difficult aspect to your second house, your finances, again, those will be resolved if there were some delays there, some unclarities, or if you have to work extra hard to secure resources and prepare to secure resources from others, through clients. Now when Mercury turns direct, you're going to start seeing more and more the results of that. And actually, Mercury becomes visible. So it's born also in Scorpio around the 21st of November. This is very rare, only for 10 days. This is a time you can suddenly give something new, can be born there. New source of income through others, new source of collaboration through others that requires you to merge your resources, new source of sexual interest as well, or even starting a more intimate conversation or some private negotiations with someone, because 8th house is private. New interest in studying something like astrology, the occult, can be born for some of you when Mercury gets retrograde in the 8th house. For some new research, to start some new research. And it's fantastic if you want to publish or bring out to the public anything connected to astrology, to the occult, to secrets, to deep research, to conspiracies, to forbidden topics, to more taboo topics like sex, like painful topics, rape, death, you know, abuse and such kind of taboo things, or very intense, deep topics, you can bring them out to the public. You can publish such things. You can, you know, launch such products like psychological therapy, you know, anything that is about healing, rejuvenation, transformation of negative states and feelings, and that touches on difficult topics. You can release such projects. Business-wise, Mercury is the planet of business, of announcements, of when it becomes visible, product bring out there, something like that. But when Mercury was retrograde in the 8th house, some of you might have had a crisis of infidelity sometimes as well, you know, finding out some old information about something connected to infidelity or betraying of trust, because this is the nature of Scorpio, finding painful secrets that are a bit traumatic. If you found such things, well, now Mercury starts moving direct in your eighth house towards the middle as well of the month. So there'll be a resolution, there'll be a conclusion, there'll be hopefully healing, moving, leaving this behind, seeing it from a different perspective. Some of you might have had to really deal with jealousy, with obsession, with more kind of thinking about such matters. Eighth house. Well, again, when Mercury starts moving direct and goes into your eighth house, again, these things will become easier, will hopefully, it might have strengthened some of your relationships if you're mainly able to deal with that or leave them behind so you can move ahead in your life. Okay, then this is, you know, there's the Pluto-Jupiter conjunction, the last one in your 10th house. This is where our hidden resources, our hidden, Pluto is something hidden, something that you did not know you had such strength to do. And Jupiter is wisdom, knowledge, opportunity. Well, some of you have, it's a last chance opportunity to make a big change and to really master their resources and make big, powerful transformation in regards to their career when Jupiter and Pluto meet up in their 10th house, possibly even create some source of wealth through their career, through something connected to institutions, governments, or connected to their own leadership's abilities of some sort. But a lot of you must have found this year abilities, leadership abilities to rule your life or yourself or others even, to construct and organize your life like never before. These are the deep secret resources that you discovered in yourself, that you're actually way more organized, that you're way more able to arrange your life, you know. And I think if you've been working on some long, for the past 1 year on something in regards to career, the Jupiter-Pluto conjunction in your 10th house now, because it's the final one, it can give you your reward. And often it's financial of sorts as well, because this is the Jupiter nature Pluto, or kind of a reputation reward, some expand your power, influence to others through your reputation now because of some project that you've completed connected to your career, or something with your connected to your career that gives, you know, some kind of growth, more power and more reward. And last but not least is the lunar eclipse in your third house. Okay, it does not affect you directly. It's on November the 30th, but you can feel it up to 2 weeks before that. And lunar eclipse is about completions, ending, seeing the results of something. And it's with Rahu, so you'll receive something for what you have been doing. So it might be some project you started before, whatever, but something connected to writing, to speaking, to communication. You can complete it. You can see results to it. Something connected to media, to marketing, to business. Third house rules all of those things. Something connected to, if you've been working in a work group environment as well, can be completed, seeing the results of, it can be bringing out some, you know, seeing the results of some product again. Third house is product that, you know, possibly connected to writing, to speaking, teaching, training, information of any sort. You can, you know, see the result of that. It can be, it can indicate some short trip as well for some of you, short trip under a month, basically, that you can fulfill. You can get excited about that. And Mercury retrograde, the third house activation happens. Then it can mean that some collaboration gives its results with a small group of people as well. It can mean, vehicles, I don't know if, vehicles, trips, okay, we talked about that. For some of you, if you've been trying to get the vehicle, this might be when you can finally. Siblings, relatives, teammates, workmates, they'll be around the end of the month, focus on those, some important developments. Let's say maybe, you know, but it's because it's a full moon, it's something that it's, you know, it's you're seeing results of and reaping rewards with. So there you go. And Libra, Venus, till, well, let's see, is in your seventh house. The most of the month? No. Till the 21st. So first, Mercury starts moving direct here. So anything complicated with relationships starts getting untangled, and contracts and agreements and clients. And then Venus till the 21st of November stays in your seventh house. So it guarantees that there is a healing of a relationship, for example, especially if there are some stresses there, that things become more erotic, more enjoyable, or if it's a business relationship, that there is improvement there, that you connect with clients easier, that you are more agreeable with others, others are more agreeable with you, you can collaborate better, you can even go on some good dates. Why not? You know, this is a good time to do that. Have some romantic time till the 21st of November. Then Venus goes in your eighth house, will bring you some money from others, some help, some rewards through others, some support, psychological, emotional, some love and interest into the occult, the forbidden, maybe some hidden action as well. So there you go. But the most important thing is your planet is turning direct. It's mostly good news, guys. Wow, Mercury is turning direct. And if you want to hear the 2021 yearly horoscopes, they're ready. They're 30% off now. I think it's like $12 or something. I'm not sure how much the administrator made them. But it's 2 hours videos for your sign Aries. And I have fantastic news for you for 2021. We Aries are going to take a leading role as some, as like a public figure or influence of many people. And not only in 2021, it will be the seeds, but for possibly 20 years ahead. And there'll be new gains that are coming for us and new friendships. And it's fantastic. It's I'm so excited finally for Aries. We deserve it. I think we passed like the trials of Hercules this year. And yes, we are deserving of what's coming, the 11th house activation from December for a whole year ahead, which is rewards time after that. So stay tuned for the December horoscopes. They will be epic, especially for us Aries, because I have such great news. I love you. But check out the paid versions, 2 hours just for you, with dates, with all the important astrological events. It's like a book of 500 pages. Thank you.